Hello again, this is LaZouche Custom here. Right, well this is part, I suppose you could say it's part two really, of my building of a Nova 1911 Colt Commander kit using basically the TM Colt Series 70 Mark IV, whatever you want to call it, as the base donor gun. And it's to prove that all of the parts, or maybe disprove, that all of the parts from this gun can be used and fitted to this kit. Now, I've been getting sort of conflicting views about Nova kits. Some of you say that they are good, that they are just a drop fit. Others say that there's problems with them. Personally speaking, I've only ever dealt with two Nova kits, and they were parts. One was a slide, one was a frame and a slide, but it were parts, they weren't full kits. And they'd already been fitted in previous people's guns, so they'd obviously been worn in. And I had no problems with them, they just straight fitted. However, this being a new kit, it took long enough to arrive, so I want to make sure that it's done properly. So this is sort of going to be new for me as well as it is for you guys. Now Nova, their previous kits were very good, so I've been told, for quality and so forth, but it seems that these new ones, they're adding bits to them and making them a lot, what should I say, they're not a lot different, but there are parts in them that don't quite make sense, or at least they didn't make sense to me when I first picked the kit up. But I shall explain that as I go through the build. Now then, first things first, we're going to be dealing with the frame in this particular video. I shall deal with the slide in the next video, hopefully. So what are we going to do? Right, well first things first, I've got to strip down the standard Colt Series 70. So let's put all these parts to one side. Now then, okay, what do we need to strip down? Well, let's take the grips off first. They are very, very tight, so always sort of look after the slot screw heads or hex heads or whatever. Always look after them, never try and damage them if you can. So take them off very, very carefully. Now you only need to take off the left hand grip because that's the one that holds the plunger spring on. And what I'm going to do now is pull that back, lift that, take your thumb safety out. Alright, so you pull the hammer back, lift it up, take it out, job done. Alright, so that's your hammer safety out of the way. Now release the hammer. Now you can take out your plunger tube, because you won't be needing that. Because, why I say you won't be needing it, is because Nova supply their own plunger tube. They also supply the indent pins that go in with it. Now you've got two pins. Actually, I suppose it'd be better if I showed you how they go in. Hopefully you can see on there the pins. You've got one with a slightly thinner end to it. That goes in up this end towards where the slide lock will be. The fatter ended long pin goes towards the rear end where your thumb safety will be. So, alright. So that goes in this tube, or plunger tube, whatever you want to call it. Now then, hopefully you can see on the video, I don't know whether you can, but as you can see the short end goes towards the slide stop end of the frame. Alright, now you literally just slot that in and push it forward. You'll know if you've got it round the wrong way, because if you turn it round the other way and put it in, it interferes with the slide stop hole. See that there? You can just about see it if I move that back. Hopefully you can see that on the camera. I'll move that forward. See how it interferes with the slide stop hole? It's in the way. So you want to make sure that it's in the correct way round. Just drop it in, slot it forward. There you are. See, it's flush with the slide stop hole. Alright. Now then, a lot of you are thinking, well hang on a minute, how is that going to stay in position? Well, the reason why it stays in position is because it's locked in. When you slide it back like that, see that, don't know whether you can, but anyway, as you slide it backwards it just drops out, and it's literally a slot fit. So you push forward, that locks it in, it's not going to move. Now the reason why that's held in there is because when the pins are in position and your thumb safety's in and slide lock's in, it can't go anywhere, it's fixed. Alright? That's why you don't need this idea that Tokyo Marui came up with, which actually I think is a better idea because it keeps the grip to lock it all in, so nothing can fly out when you take the thumb safety off, it's not going to go anywhere, whereas this little bugger could. But anyway, as I say, it's just a side note. So, let's put that to one side. Actually, I'm going to put the springs and pins and so forth back in. So, slot those back in like this. So there we are. So that's how it will be, like that, when it goes in. Alright, so let's put that to one side. Let's put the grips to one side, and we won't need that now. By the way, the spring you would use out of this. The two pins you don't need because they come with an over kit, but the spring you will need. Alright, so, but I've got a spare one out of my spares box, so I can leave that as is. Alright, let's put our grip screws to one side, and our thumb safety to one side. Now then, it doesn't matter how you strip this down, whichever way you do it, doesn't really matter. So let's just take the magazine catch out. That's it, yep, hands released. So I'm going to take out. Now then, this is where it gets a little bit tricky to do on camera, so I'm going to have to do this slightly off camera. But what I'm going to do is use the rod that you get with the high capper kit, or a thin pin or something like that, that you can hold against your mainspring pin there. Alright, so you just hit it against there, and I'm just going to tap it out. Alright, so I'm going to have to do this on my knee off camera because it's easier to do. That's it, and it goes on the floor. There we are, that's our spring, see that? I've just knocked it through like so. Alright, so we can slide that out now, don't need that. To one side, and out comes your mainspring housing. Alright, so you can leave that as is, there's no need to touch that. And also, out comes your grip safety. You'll be using that as well, hopefully. And then you can take out your sear spring. Now that, it's got two names, it's either a sear spring or your three finger spring. So you've got two names for that. I personally call it a sear spring, but there we are, each to his own. Right, okay, now then, let's undo this screw. As I say, you can do it any way you like, but I usually undo the side screw first. Get that out. Like so, put that to one side, because we don't want to lose it. Put the tools back over this side. Got that out of the way. Now we can undo our Phillips head screw that's inside the frame there. Hopefully you can see that on camera. So just take that out. Now luckily enough I've got a magnetic screwdriver, which is very helpful. Put that to one side. Now then, using the same pin that I used before, I'm just going to pop out the disconnector pin and the hammer pin, or sear pin and hammer pin. It's two different pins. There we go. Take those out. You'll find they're slightly oily, or they should be. Then your disconnector will drop out. Don't worry, it's meant to fall out. It's just how it's built. Now then, the other way to, or the correct way, how I've found the easiest way to get this inner frame out, is to place your fingers on that side, like so. Put your thumb, literally this fleshy bit of your thumb, against your knocker valve actuator. Alright, so you put that on there, and then you slowly begin to slide it out. Now the reason why your thumb is on there is because you don't want that little spring that's in there going ping and flying off and disappearing into the wild blue yonder. Alright, so as you come out, you'll feel the spring. Just slide the body out. I'll put that to one side and I'll show you what I mean without losing that spring. There's a spring just in there. Alright, you can just about make it out hopefully under this light. Might be a bit bright actually, so I'll darken it down a little bit. There we go. There's your spring there. You don't want to lose that, and you want to keep this all as is. You're not going to be touching this. So, I'll put that to one side. I'll clean the grease and muck off my hands because we don't want it going in areas we don't need it. Right, now there should be plenty of grease on that frame as is. You shouldn't need to put any more grease on there as it's come from the factory. You'd be able to tell that because if you look down inside the frame, there's all like liquid grease in there, whatever you want to call it, oil, synthetic oil. You'll be able to see it inside there. Alright, but if it is dry, then obviously just give it a little bit of a lube with the synthetic oil, either silicon or synthetic. This, I've been told, is actually synthetic, although I've classed it as silicon in the past, but it's actually synthetic oil. It says on the back, actually, but there we are. Obviously, I didn't read it correctly at the time. Right, now then, now you can pop out your trigger bow. Thus, alright, careful not to damage it, because that, again, we're going to be using. We're not going to be swapping the trigger over. I am going to be customising this eventually to suit my needs, but for the moment I thought it's only fair that I do a straight cross kit to show you how easy or maybe how hard these kits are to put together. So I thought for the likes of you out there that are not sort of really technically minded or just want a straight drop fit kit, so that's why I'm doing this video, so it proves that you can use all the parts from the Series 70 in the Nova kit. Alright. Okay, well there's nothing left on there other than the grip, but we don't need to bother about that for the moment because we won't be fitting it just yet, so we can put that to one side. Now then, this is the tricky part now. Now you should have enough lubricant on there, but actually there isn't, so I'm going to get some lubricant. Silicon lube. Just place a little bit on that side and a little bit on that side. That is it. You don't need to put any more than that on there. Hopefully you can see that on the camera. If this camera will focus in. Is that going to focus? No, but anyway, it's hardly any on there. Alright, so you just need to put a little bit on there. Very difficult to do this on camera, but there we go. Right, so we just put a little bit on the trigger bow. It should just slot straight in, which it does. Very nicely. It's a little bit tight, but it's not too bad. That will do nicely. See that? Quite nice. Right, okay, let's just wipe this muck off my fingers. Put that down in there. Now then, to hold our trigger in place, exactly the same as the TM way of doing it, as you twist that round. Now then, let's hope we don't have a problem like I did have on my last TM kit, where the hole for the screw was in the wrong place, and I don't believe it. It's exactly the same problem. See, Nova kits. No, it's working. I don't believe it. It's actually working. The previous Nova kit I had, you turned that screw and it just jammed up inside. It had to be refitted, but actually that's working this time. I don't believe it, but it is. That's alright. Good. Alright, okay, that's working. A little bit of heart in mouth there, but it's working now, so don't worry about getting this grease anywhere for the moment. I'll clear that up as we go. Okay, right, so that's those two parts in. Now we can place this in, but there is a but. Nova supply this, which is a slide bar spacer. Now, I think I did a video about where and when to use this. You can buy them separately. I think Creation do one, Airsoft Surgeon I think do one, and Tanya Koba do one, or used to. These are good little things. They're okay if you're fitting the old style high kappa design slide to single stack TM frames. They just add a bit more strength to the slide rails, that's all. Frame rails, I should say. But Nova supply them, so I'm going to fit them because their slide is slightly different in design, so I am going to fit it. Oops. And it's a better fit than any of the other slide rails that I've got. So I'm going to fit that in. Oh, excuse me, my dinner's repeating on me. Right, now then. What you want to do now is disengage the sear. Actually, that's got to be down. you can see on camera, but there is a slight line. Oops, no, I'm going off camera here. There is a slight line which is just there, where this frame is in a frame, is not dropping down on it.